This is a production of PBS 39.
Well, it doesn't feel like fall quite yet, but winter will be here before you know it. To get you in the mood, our history highlight tonight takes us back to 1954 and a huge snowstorm that blanketed the East Coast. You'll also see a barrel jumping contest on ice and Mrs. Dwight D. Eisenhower christening the world's first atomic-powered submarine.
The entire middle Atlantic seaboard, from Maine on south, is blanketed with the heaviest snowstorm in 5 years. New York, Boston, Philadelphia, and Washington all have scenes such as these. Motorists are particularly hard hit as ice forms under the snow in the bitter temperatures. In New York, traffic is brought almost to a standstill at the height of the storm, and hundreds of thousands of commuters abandon their cars in favor of public transportation. Throughout the metropolitan area, suburbs are buried under 8 inches of snow with more to come. But the birds eat just the same, as the householder shovels. But every snowstorm has its silver lining, and it belongs to the kids. During the past years of mild winters, they have rarely had this chance. Roll out the barrel. The 1954 Jumping Championship gets off to a bone-crunching start on the skating rink at Grossinger's, New York. Regional champs from Europe, Canada, and the U.S. have a go at unseating the world's champion, but most of them end up unseating themselves. Lady Luck has got them over the barrel, but good. There'll be a lot of eating off the mantelpiece for the next few days. You've heard the expression, putting one's foot in it. Terry Brown of Detroit has heard it. But then Terry jumped over 14 barrels for a distance of 25 feet, 11 inches, to retain his barrel jumping title. That's it. He gets his trophy from another champ, Rocky Marciano. At Groton, Connecticut, a new naval era dawns with the launching of the Nautilus, one of the largest submarines ever built, and the first atomic-powered craft in history. It may well initiate a revolution in naval warfare. Some 20,000 are on hand, foremost among them, Mrs. Dwight D. Eisenhower, who will christen the historic vessel. In the yards below, Commander Eugene P. Wilkinson, skipper of the Atom Sub, oversees the actual launching, just seconds away. The historic moment is at hand. The launching cradle is released, and as the Nautilus slides down the ways, Mrs. Eisenhower christens it with a valiant blow. With its pioneer model atomic power plant, the Nautilus has an underwater speed higher than most surface ships, an underwater range limited only by its crew's endurance. At once a formidable fighting ship and a forerunner of commercial atomic power, the Nautilus heralds a new era of the atomic age.